Never meant to be such a crazy affair. No, and who I Alright, hello everyone, welcome to today's stream, where we will be starting our Muramasa playthrough, although I will tell you right now that before I streamed, like ever, period, so like 2 years ago or something, I played this game, and I didn't like it that much. So we'll see if I was just being a poopy head before, or if it's legitimately just not my thing, or maybe a bad game. The reviews are largely, like, I think, like a 7 or 8 out of 10, so, but, you know, how many of them are weeaboos? That's the question you have to ask yourself in the morning. About anything. How many of them are weeaboos? Because I'm not a weeaboo. Although I do love the art style. Because it's actually, like, good anime. It's not just cheaply made crap. What you gonna play if you don't like it? We'll see if, I mean, if I don't like it and we're like 2 hours in by the time I decide that I don't like it, then, you know, that's probably it for the day. But yeah, if it's within like 45 minutes, I'll probably switch. But I don't have a specific game in mind. It's gonna take me 5 minutes to switch anyway, so. Marvelous Entertainment. Let me know if the audio is okay, folks. It might be a little bit loud, but let me know. Demon, blood, and fate. My three favorite things on Mondays. The that thigh, though. And the slight little butt cheek down there. My TV settings, like... I feel like my TV settings are a little too sharp for me. Let's go check that. Lower the sound a little, you got it. Let me know how that is. Yeah, that looks a little better on my end. You guys won't notice a difference, but I thought my TV was a little too sharp. I was seeing too many pixels. I mean, I know it's standard definition, so... But even then. Also, I have to get used to having an uncheck that doesn't have a wire in it. I do have a wireless nunchuck now. I just have to get used to it because the sizing is a little different, and it's also, there's no wire, which is very weird, honestly, after playing with the Wii for years with a wire. It's very weird to play without a wire. I will press A, and I will hit new game. Vanilla Wire. That's not a very flattering name, is it? Cut through enemies easily, progress steadily, even if you're not skilled at action games. To advance, you must evade, defend, and use arts masterfully. Oh, okay, this is like... It's not a playing style, it's a difficulty mode. I'm gonna stick with normal. I don't recall what I played years ago, but like I said, I just didn't... I thought it was, like, tedious years ago. The only thing I remember from playing it years ago is that, the jumping in the game is stupid. You press up on the control stick to jump. That's dumb. That's stupid. That's no. Just no. Alright, so, Momohime or Kisuki. Kisuki's the male, that's the female. They do have technically different bosses and things, and of course a different storyline, but I don't recall anything about the story, so probably not that important at the end of the day. But I played Kisuki last time, so I'll go ahead and play Kisuki this time and see if it's, you know, just not my thing or what have you. Controls tutorial. Yeah, see, control stick up to jump. That's just terrible. Why would you do that? Hold down after jumping to glide. Okay. Why would I glide? I can't move left or right. Press up again after jumping to perform a double jump. I already did that game. all the coding in the world, and they couldn't realize that I was past this already. I mean, of course, the animations are great, and like I said, I love the art style. Hold down to crouch. I guess you can't do combos when you're crouching. I have to press down each time I want to dodge? Not sure how I feel about that. Hold down A while crouching and then release to perform a drawn backslash. Oh, okay. All right. That's deep. Okay. That's neat. A little bit odd. It's weird because when you hold down A for the down move, the character actually like does something to indicate he's ready to do it. But when you do the uppercut, he doesn't do anything. So I didn't even know that he was, like, ready to actually do it. Because until you actually hit the control stick up, he won't do anything. To indicate that he's actually responding to what you're pressing. A little weird. Especially when it's not consistent with the other move. Okay, there you go. Three times in a row. Okay. On the air, hold A down. Okay, there you go. Let's speed to unleash the secret arts. I like how doing the special move is just one button. That's it. Basic moves, fucking complicated. This thing, nothing. Basic button. Be sure to discover my ass. Woods. I don't know why my ass is in the woods, but it is. Hold A down to enter a parrying stance. Okay. Weird how your attack button is also your block button, but alright. Okay, alright, I like this. It's weird, you feel like there would be a delay for when you hit A to actually attack, so you would attack earlier, but no, you should really attack when it's about to hit you. So it's actually instant, even though it doesn't feel instant, that's the weird thing. Okay, so blocking actually reduces your blade's thingy. You can't defend when your blade is broken. Okay. Press C to switch to a new blade. Okay. Blade gouge, lights up. The gouge. Cage. I always do that with that word. The only word that I do that with. When gauge lights up again, okay. Wait until the blade gouge. Gauge, fuck me, I can't say that word. And attacks all enemies on screen. Okay, alright. I don't think I utilized that last time I played that much, which I should. The game does tell me to do it. Okay, there you go. That was awkward, but alright. You have to really get used to the controls. They're not... It's not smooth, Like, it may look smooth, but it's not smooth. At least not right now. I do like, though, that there's nothing that pauses the action. So switching your blade and even using items doesn't stop the game. It's weird that they reverse the numbers, so usually, at least in English games, this is an English release, obviously, but in English games, the total for your health would be on the right part of it, but it's on the left part. My current health is on the right part. It's just, I don't know why they didn't bother to just switch them around. That should be a pretty easy thing to do. I want to try the tutorial again. No, I get it. I probably forgot some things, but, you know. Alright, so I have a bamboo flask. No rice balls, just bamboo flasks. Okay. By collecting souls, you can gradually replenish your base soul power. Okay, so collect souls. And you can't go down once you jump up. Okay. Only glide for like a short time. Super awkward. And the jumping being up on the control stick is pretty terrible. I like my jumping to be done with a button, thanks. Oh, hello. I mean, so far the best thing about this game is definitely the graphics and the animation. They are quite amazing. Is that all of them? Yeah, okay. That was neat. I feel like I'm gonna get this game this time. I don't think I got it last time, you know? Like, when a game clicks with you. Because I feel like it's clicking more than it did when I first played it. Because it doesn't play like other action games. It's a little slower and more methodical. Got a healing pellet. Okay. What does a healing pellet even do? Does it put it in my bag? Okay, it is actually an item. Okay. I don't know what what does bamboo flask do? Can I see my inventory? Yeah, there we go. It restores 80 life flame. Okay, so it does restore my life. Wait, what does a life pellet do? Because I can't use I can't use the healing pellet. Weird. I can use the bamboo flask right now, but I can't use the healing pellet, but my life is full, so why can I? Okay, whatever. Maybe I didn't read it all. I don't care. It's fine. Okay. All right. So far, no hits taken. And I'm pretty sure that's like the point of combat in this game, is really to just get through it without taking any damage. Whee! The jumping is still awkward for the record, even though I said wee. I mean, the running animation is like one of my favorite things. I like how they turn their head while they run. It's very subtle, but very cool looking. I could just watch the running animation forever, honestly. Samurai are troublesome enemies capable of defending themselves. Break their blades, however, they will no longer be able to protect themselves. First line attack can be to snap their weapons in two. Run backslash is really effective. Okay. I forgot how to do the drawn backslashes. And what sucks, though, is that you can't attack unless the enemies are on screen. So you can't even take your blade out to, like, that kind of do it. Like, I don't know. I forgot how to... Can I see controls? Item shortcut abilities. No? No. That sucks. I forgot how to do the backslash thing. I know it's like something about down and shit, and I know the game just kind of told me, but I figured I remembered, but no, I didn't. Is that everyone dead? Yeah? Okay. Yeah, if you take, like, any damage, you could see I took, like, what, maybe one or two hits. Took quite a bit of my health already. Bamboo Flask 2, cool. Moving on up in the world. Okay, there you go. That's how you do it. They escaped? Okay. Not sure what that enemy was, besides... flying around. What were they like? Were they trying to kill me or no? The more of them. Had to stay up in the air to avoid the bombs. Flame breath. Okay. That all of them? Alright, cool. So many souls! Yeah, I can see why I don't remember any part of the story, because there is no story so far. There is no story. Where'd you go? Why does he keep running away? What is he? Are you a faggot or a ninja? Jesus. Running away. Such honor. I know there's a boss coming up. I leveled up. Okay. I don't think there's actually stat points you allocate or anything. I think you just get more health. That's about it. Guys have more health now or something. Okay. I mean, so far, I think I'm getting the game more than I did 2 years ago, for whatever reason. Because the combat's flowing pretty nicely. I can save my adventure. Okay, so they have save points. All right. Sure to save your progress. Wouldn't want to forget the penetration. Never forget the penetration. Alright, I am as ready as I can be for the battle. I'm ready, game. Please fuck my ass. Yes. Do it. Fuck me with your Wii.
恐ろしい奴よ。
Okay, so apparently I'm a traitor. Okay. That's a plot point. We have a plot point officially. Oh, okay, so I'm a traitor and an amnesiac. Good. Those go hand in hand quite often, I think. Wait, I can talk to other characters? Why would I talk to him, though? So I guess I just leave. Oh. The third guy. But I don't have a boss, I'm unemployed. Self-employed, I mean. I am my own boss. Odd that an English translated game would still have the Japanese voiceover in it. Not like usually they do English dubs, but all right. At least the voice acting is pretty good. I'm gonna leave. I can't leave? Okay. I leave and then I guess I fight them is what I'm assuming is gonna happen. Them graphics. Let the bodies hit the floor.
I'm
sorry, are you a ninja or like what's the term they use? The splicers. Yeah, are you a splicer from BioShock or a ninja? Can't quite tell the difference. Hey, okay, whoa. Got it. Oh, he actually has a second health bar. Okay. All right. That's a problem. Yeah. I knew that was gonna break.
Yeah.
This blade is also broken. Oh, that's not good. All the blades are broken, and also the phone call. Why the phone call? Gotta focus here. Nobody important. Like always. Okay, I need a blade that's not broken. There we go, that's no longer broken. Ow. Ow, ow, ow. Yeah, that's okay. Alright. I think he still has a whole nother health bar, too. That was terrible. That was a terrible use of the special. All right. Got it. We got it. Oh, just narrowly avoiding those attacks. I remember that boss giving me way more trouble 2 years ago. Like I said, I think the combat system is actually clicking with me this time. Because that was handled actually pretty well. I only needed to use like 3 healing items. And I have a new sword. Okay. Yay! I kind of like it, honestly. So far. I feel like it's clicking with me. That's what I feel is different. It used to not click with me. She's a fox. Is that like literally a fox? I mean, I think it's literally a fox, and also like a fox isn't a hot chick, but you know. What's the difference? I kind of dropped my nunchuck because I forgot that it doesn't have a wire attached to it. Because I'm used to, like, having the nunchuck just, like, hang. But, yeah. Can't do that because it doesn't have a wire.
That
is a long... I'm not going to wait for the Japanese sound to be over because some of that shit is, like, way too long for just saying what that is. You turned into a pretty lady just for this. I might as well listen to what you have to say. Wow. Wow. I relate to my character. No, I don't. She's not even a pretty lady. She's a pretty fox. Come on. She's a Neko.
Basically.
Did they tell her to voice act in a way that was like half sex noises and like half regular talking? Because it sounds like she's moaning every word. Just a little bit. Just a little bit every word. See? Listen to that. That sounds like they're having sex. Just a little bit. The fox is more so pronounced. At least my main character doesn't sound like that, but all these women just sound like they're just having fucking sex while they're talking to them. Okay, that's like the most normal one so far.
徳川家に不吉と言われ、一度抜けば血を見るまで鞘に収まらねえって。室町の頃を生きられた村政殿にございますが。おや、あなた様の持つ立場、村政は並ならぬ霊とゆえ、たとえ折れようとも。
Can I go in that? Oh, that's not a building. Okay. So, do I just leave? I mean, I couldn't really, like, accept the request, quote-unquote. Yeah, okay. So when you leave, you just mean, like, continue the cutscene. Okay. You get several Muramasa, actually. You have several of them. You have four now. The only thing sexist here is my ass. I don't know what that means. Thought I had a joke there, but I'm incorrect. I can equip three blades and one accessory. I do have another blade. I don't have any accessories, though. Okay, required strength 3-3. That's like the weakest blade, and it has the Nightglow secret arc, which is that hack one. Alright, what's the, Nagasone? L-Spinner. Ooh! It does require more stuff, and it has a poison effect. And it has way more attack. Go ahead and swap that out. You can only have three blades equipped, so. And I doubt you can equip blades, like, in the middle of shit, so. March into the ninja base in Iga province to learn your past. Okay. Oh, I go left? I have to go left now? Okay. I mean, I feel like it's clicking a lot more with me than it is the last time. Because I remember that boss gave me way more trouble the first time I played this game, and I feel like I was playing it too much like a straight 2D action game. Because it doesn't play like a straight 2D action game. You're only inputting about two things at once max, and that's it. And you have to wait until the thing finishes before you can input something again, really. So it's a lot slower paced, which isn't bad as long as you get it, so to speak. Like, you have to understand that it's not like it, like it looks like it, it looks like, I'm sure when you're watching me play it, it looks like a straight up regular action thing, but it's actually rather slow paced. I'm not pressing many buttons. You have to be deliberate in what you're trying to do, so it's not like a spammy thing. I don't think I understood that 2 years ago is what I'm saying. Was this like a new building or like... No, okay, this is the same house, alright. It just wants me to go left now for some reason. I do wish the HUD was smaller, but it does get out of the way when you're actually fighting, so... Not too much of an issue. Because, I mean, the only thing you're, like... The game does separate between fighting and not fighting, so the map being there isn't too much of an issue, honestly. I wish you could turn off the HUD, though, just to be able to see the graphics, because that's the thing. You have all these beautiful graphics, and it's covered up by this HUD. Like I said, I could watch that running animation for fucking hours. It's hypnotic. I don't know why they want me to go left all this way. Oh, so I can drop down. See, I thought I couldn't drop down. So here's the stupid thing. If you hold down, he won't drop from it. But if you quickly tap it, he'll go down. I think that's a little silly. I don't know why they need to distinguish between the two. Because in most games, it's just if you press down and then the jump button, which this game does not have a jump button, then you would go down. This game doesn't have a jump button. Yep, now I can get rid of red barriers. There you go. He's so pretty. So pretty. Although the leaf petals animation could be, I guess, a little smoother. That's like 5 frames of animation. I mean, it's a lot more frames of animation, but it's done so slowly. So there's like maybe 20 frames of animation, but it's doing it at like 1 frame every second and a half. So it looks really stilted. Whereas like the character animation is very nice. Like that's probably 30 frames of animation and probably 30 FPS. So I don't know if this game runs at 30 or 60. I can't tell. It's harder to tell with 2D games whether it's running at 30 FPS or 60 FPS. It's just harder to tell from it. Why is it so hard to hit? It's like the hitbox of it is like nothing. Did I win? Jesus. I found out the quickest way to hit it is actually just with the quick draw. She keeps, like, she might be there, but she actually starts disappearing, like, when you get near her, so you can't actually hit her. But yeah, I figured it out. Quick draw was the way to kill it easily, because you don't have to actually be near anything to actually kill something. Quick draw. There you go. Yeah, I knew that he was a samurai, so I had to break his blade. Whee! This is about as far as I got, by the way, about 2 years ago. I remember this city, but after that I thought the game was like too tedious or something, or I just didn't click with it, like I said. Like I said, now I'm clicking with it. And they clearly want you to be deliberate with your moves because they want you to not take any damage for each fight. And I like that the fights aren't random, actually. Although that's no different than most action games. It's not like action games have grinding in them. Is there actually anything to get? No? Okay. I didn't know if there was anything to open in the house. There was a skull back there. Yeah, these are all pretty easy. Like I said, I remember having a lot more difficulty with the game. I don't know if I was playing hard mode, though, at the time. I don't know. Because I don't think you can change difficulties mid-game. I don't know if I was playing hard mode last time or not. But even then, I don't feel like I got the combat system. So if I was playing on hard mode, that just compounded the issue of me not getting it. Okay.
Yeah, quite, quite.
So then I stuff them away in my mouth. There's nothing scarier than tea? That's, okay, glad we had this conversation. I'm gonna leave now. But that was, glad they included that in the game. But the game wants me to go left, but there's actually another, map to the right. This has an item in it. Oh, there's an item here. Yeah. Yeah, you can really move around the battlefield. I also like, actually, that... See, most 2D games, period, they never, like, stop the camera from scrolling. But in this game, when you have a battle, you don't really need to worry about the camera scrolling most of the time. There's only been, like, maybe two or three battles where the camera actually was able to scroll. Otherwise, it was locked to the area you were fighting in, which is actually really good. One less thing to have to worry about, a bad camera or something like that. Yeah, got an item here. I also missed an item in the other map, but I don't know if I'm going to bother going back for every little thing. I'm sure I have to go this way at some point anyway, so I'm going to head back the other way. I mean, there's not much in the way of exploration, I would say. I mean, every room I've gone into has just been one or two enemies, and that's it. So, not much to really go on there. It's kind of like Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, except not shitty open world. Huh. 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 Hello, foxy lady. I can pass your barrier. I don't need a demon blade. I need a demon dick. That's what I need. We'll get right on that. That's a nice little effect there. That's actually a 2D, is that a 2D drawing? I can't tell, honestly. Is that just a 2D drawing that they just, drew multiple times? I want to say it's actually a 3D image. I want to say it's a 3D image. That is just, you know, modeled in a way to look 2D. Very nice effect, though. An item here. That looks like there's food in there. Oh! Hello, cooking mama. You came in here just like a thief. Bitch, I came in here and bowed to you, so make me some fucking dinner. Okay. Yields 1,200 spirit. Sushi. Lobster tempura. I have 415 money. I don't know. I guess I'm eating it. Nom. You have to press A to eat it every time. That's hilarious. Nom nom nom. Nom 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 nom. It's like a quick time event. Okay. Is spirit also like my experience? I think that's what it is. I think it also is like... Let's see. I'm now able to use a map. Thanks. Oh, can I forge blades now too? Is that a thing that happened at some point? From this game, you can create a new demon blade. Complete a blade, you need souls that are obtained from your enemies and spirit, and can be gained. Okay, so souls are also used. Okay, so that's what souls are for. Alright. You need to forge blades in order, as shown as the blade lineage tree. Okay. They mean linear tree. That is linear. By completing a particular path, you'll gain the ability to create the blade you're striving to acquire. Plan carefully as you forge your weapon. Okay, so I can go this way, which has the night glow or two flame. I have to create the Kasuke first. No? I guess I don't have to, because it says press A to create, but I'm assuming I guess I already have that one. Oh, I see. I already have these blades, so it's not like you're upgrading the blade, it's more like you're unlocking new blades. Okay. So these are the blades I can unlock, or these ones. Lice, Phantom 1, Effect Income Boost, Bad Tummy, Iron Wall. Open this one. Bang! How many bangs do I have to see before he does it. I just press A? I guess I just press A. Okay. I have the Hayate Muramasa. Okay. I have plenty of souls left. So. And again, it's not like you lose any blades, so you're just unlocking new ones. Cannot forge this blade. I guess you earn that blade. I guess, oh, okay, so these blades are blades that you must get as the story progresses. Okay. I got you. I don't have enough soul for that. I guess I don't have enough. Oh, I have plenty of spirit. I don't have enough souls. Okay. Souls I get from enemies. All right. I can make this blade then. You do not have enough strength and vitality yet to equip this blade. Okay, so if I don't have enough strength and vitality, that's no point. Okay, so I can't make that one, and therefore I can't make this one. Okay. And now I have new blades. Yep, I have new blades. Alright, so attack 11. This is the weakest one now. I get one that's stronger. Hayate Muramasa. Let's go ahead and put the Hayate in there. Cool. Alright, cool. There you go. I mean, the effect is also something to be aware of, but, I mean, 11 attack up to 17 attack, that's way better. Hello, Grandpa. Okay, I understood about 5% of what you were talking about. So, good job. That's a new record for you, Gramps. Oh, I see. You can tap C multiple times to get the blade that you're looking for specifically. Okay. I was going to say, you have to switch in order? No, you just tap C multiple times. I was trying to do the special move at some point in that fight, but I didn't realize my meter wasn't full enough. Just because the thing is blinking up top, that just means the quick switch is available, not that the sword actually has its ability up. Okay, I'm supposed to just repel the flames. Got it. Okay, so those fights, you're not... At least for that fight, anyway. I wasn't supposed to actually kill them. I was supposed to just deflect the flames they were doing out. Okay, this is interesting, I guess. a locked thing. I guess I can't open this yet, can I? Okay. Oh, okay, so those blades are all red blades, so they can only break red barriers. I don't think I have any green blades. No, I don't. But I need a blade with a green color. Okay. So that's my goal, so I need to explore, I guess, or find the blade that has a green color. Got it. I understand, Sensei. Me the ways of the ninja. Oh, okay. These are new. Okay. I like that you can, quite easily, it seems, at least, get through combat without taking any hits. Oh, is this my actual goal? Okay. That was my actual goal. I didn't need to even go to the barrier. So now I am traveled to Iga. Okay. Oh, whoa, that is fucking neat as fuck, dude. That is cool. That is nice. I could just, wow. That, literally hypnotic. Oh, they only use that effect once. Oh. I guess they didn't want any of the art assets to keep doing it. Did take a hit there. I don't know how the game defines a quick win. It's not like they have a timer, do they? If they do, I'm not noticing it. I'm too busy focusing on what I'm doing. What's this? Okay, so that's another berry. I need a purple blade for that. Smoke bomb? What do I do with a smoke bomb? Lets you escape from non-boss battles. Okay. Press that to select what you will utilize in your item shortcuts, then to use an item press. Okay, so this is actually, that menu is no different than doing it in-game. So, there you go. That menu is kind of pointless unless you want to do it without. I guess they're giving you the option of not doing it in the midst of a battle, assuming you can open the menu in the middle of a battle. But if you want to make it more a casual experience, there you go. I mean, granted, I'm on normal, but you know, I mean, the game's not unforgiving, but I mean, you could tell I can only take like 5 hits and I'm dead. I'm sure on hard mode maybe they lower that to like 2 hits. I gotta get the soul so I can upgrade the swords. Not upgrade, but get new ones. At this point, this is all blind to me, because I never made it past this point in the game, so. But apparently I never even played it for 2 hours, which I thought I did. Played it for less than an hour. Yeah, you told me that before, bitch. Why don't you give me a blade? Either give me a blade or get naked. I mean, either way. At least be useful. Whoa, what is this? Okay. I was gonna get gangbanged by a bunch of midgets? Alright then. Still alive. Ow. Confused. There's still somebody alive. Oh. What are you doing down here? The party's up there. Hard to avoid the bombs in such tight quarters. There we go. Oh, they're certainly mixing up the combat very nicely. There's also a sequel to this game, apparently, and or a remake or something on the Wii U. I have no idea if it's a sequel or a remake. I mean, it's just called Muramasa Rebirth, which makes me think it's some kind of remake. Oh, barrier. But you would need to buy a Wii U for that, and, you know, nobody bought a Wii U, just like nobody's buying a goddamn Switch. Nintendo. Oh, this is cool. Oh, look at that. That's so fucking cool. Oh, that fucking little effect. So subtle, but so brilliant. Go ahead, throw another one. Oh. Stylish. I didn't get any bonus points for reflecting shit? Come on now, game. I don't know if the blades have different attack speeds. How was that a quick draw finish? I didn't do a quick draw. I used my special ability. I didn't use a quick draw. Nailed it. Again, I think level ups are rather pointless. I mean, all it does is give me more health, really. I'm like, that's so cool! Like every other map, they have this weird ass effect. And yeah, the point of the blades breaking is... See, this is like a weapon durability system that makes sense. See, like, most games that have a weapon durability system, they don't really have an in-depth combat system that is standard, so to speak, between weapons, whereas this game does. All the weapons control the same, right? So it's a same combat system throughout, and your weapons also recharge. So it's kind of like... reversing the trope of durability systems, because most games have a durability system with weapons for the purposes of trying to quote-unquote mix up the combat by changing up the combat system, so to speak, because a spear doesn't necessarily handle the same as a sword in those games, right? And usually those games get off on, you know, being like, oh, we have 20 billion different weapons that you can attack with, right? And they all control differently. And the problem with that is, again, you're losing flow with the gameplay because you're basically changing the combat system. This game doesn't do that. It has the same combat system for all your weapons, and your weapons regenerate over time. So really the point is to sort of remember your special abilities and use them appropriately. And also the quick draw system, which also actually aids the flow of battle, because they create sort of a rhythm effect. They create sort of it as a rhythmic gameplay for you, where you flash the thing then when they want you to do the quick draw thing. So it creates a rhythm to the combat, which is a good thing for the durability system, because that's kind of like what other games try to do, but again, they fail because they're changing up the combat system by making you switch from drastically different weapons in terms of how they control. That's just not the case in this game. So yeah, this is how you do a durability system in a video game. This is why you do it. Use it to serve as a method of changing up the combat in a small way, rather than sort of making it a grind to sort of constantly be acquiring new weapons or anything like that. That's just annoying. This is like the only durability system I know of that's actually not annoying. Like a fisheye view, it's so weird. Alright, getting up on that, a little annoying. Ow. Oh, come on, really? No, game, this is why you want your jump button to, you know, be a button and not a control stick. It's also very floaty. Oh my god. It's like the first battle where they've actually made jumping part of the combat, and this is the fucking result. Fucking terrible. Getting hand cramps now because of this crap.
Oh,
Where'd he go? Ah, for fuck's sake. Ah, why? My wrist is all fucked up because of this crap. Oh my god, it's so dumb. Let's have a shitty jumping mechanic and combine it with our combat system that's actually good. No, the result is bad. Oh my god. You could at least if they had like a ledge grab thing, that'd be cool. Either make a ledge grab mechanic or make your platforms bigger with your floaty ass jump controls that are controlled with a goddamn control stick. You have to do like a claw thing with your fucking nunchucks. Boss time. I'm ready.
このキスケは逃げも隠れもしねえ。手間暇省いて俺の方から来てやったぜ。大将はどこだ？出てきやがれ！裏切り者と呼ばわったぜ。
I don't know why they have the cutscene and then they switch to this and have me talk to them. I guess it's to make the cutscene quote-unquote shorter by making some of the dialogue quote-unquote optional. But, like, this is not the way to go about it. Especially when they have plot points in this. If you're going to tell me the plot point game, then tell me the plot point. Don't make it an optional plot point. I'm sorry, is he the one with like Down syndrome or something?
これはしたり、年派もいかぬに並ならぬ腕前。
されど
所詮は忍び如きの芸当。異様な殺気をまといやがる。こいつ相当にできる。
He remembers the style of swordsmanship, but he doesn't remember anything else. Seems odd.
今すぐに切り捨ててくれるわ。And
by proceed, they mean start the actual boss fight.
谷の結界封印を破ったのはそのたちか。
Is the giant centipede anything like the human centipede? Because I'd be kind of into
that.
So to a Shirazu Fu or Toitana. What in the same you are chine?
Oh. Okay. I don't think I should touch those. Oh, they're actually separate parts. That's interesting. Okay, I can touch them. It's just the head that's the problem. Okay, this is a very interesting boss. And combat system, then. 300 combo! And I can actually stand on... Can I stand on? Blades of Breath is great. Okay, this is an interesting fight, but also incredibly easy, it seems. I also don't know if the frame rate's tanking or just because I'm using special abilities so much. The combo doesn't go past 999? Okay. I broke the combo system. Whoa, it actually tried hitting me. They're just like health sponges. Okay, whoa, okay. Alright, that was not a good. So downplayed, though. The game soundtrack isn't bad either. It's so in the background. Yeah, that's a hard power to land. I mean, Cyclone is like the best sword for this situation. I like how it freeze frames while you select your sword. That's very nice. But they're so health spongy. I think I have to kill the head and then break the body. Yeah, I have to kill the head and break the body. That's why I have to actually. Okay. I have to get to the head. There you go. Now I can break. There you go. Okay, so it's not that the boss is health spongy, it's that I actually wasn't doing it right. Because they weren't actually... Yeah, I see. Now it's showing damage numbers on the body. Actually, no, it is showing damage numbers on the body even when the head's going back. I'm a little confused. Do I have to take the head out first? I mean, taking the head out makes the body stop, so... Crap. I don't know if I'm doing it correctly or not. I mean, I am beating it, so. But I think I do have to cut the head off first. I mean, I know I killed one of them. Okay, that was almost dead. Got it. Alright, one more left. There you go. Sort of like an endurance rat, in a way. I just don't think they attack enough, though. It's a very neat concept for a boss, though, I will say that. I really like how the game changes up the gameplay consistently, very like throughout every fight, not even just boss fights. Cyclone's the best sword here. Spam that special. Yeah, so killing the head is not necessary, but killing the head does stop the body from moving. But it's not necessary to destroy parts of the body. It's just that they are very health spongy, in fact. That was a bad. Yeah, Hell Spinner is the worst. Very nice. That was good. I think a little too much health, but it didn't overstay its welcome. And it was I appreciate the concept of the boss more than anything. And now I can destroy orange berries. Okay. I need a drink.
Kai Senban. Omuka de no kai arawaru nado to hito ni hanaseba warai uza. あやつの現実に皆が騙されたなら下人風情と侮っておったがなかなかどうして惜しいやつ。
So honor is thrown out the window as long as I'm useful?
たぶらかしおったなキスケ。化け物などこの世におるものか。
おい。さっきの続きが聞きて。
鳴神藩の下隠す宝刀を奪いに行く使命じゃった。公儀は気に食わぬ小藩の落ち度を探し取り潰しておる。徳川に近畿の村政を隠しておれば理由に不足はない。
怨霊を切り伏せたその構え。伊豆田甚九郎と同じ剣を使う者。
その方を殺すのはちと惜しくなってきた。どうだ。キスケとやら腕申し出を受けるなら伊賀の上人らに働きかけ抜け人一匹赦免いたすよ。
無産くせえ話だが突っぱねるのは早計か。この
くだんの鳴神で藩主鏡の娘虎姫が改易を不服としてハントとなって伊吹捕らえたいが姫に化け物がついたとの噂が立ち少々手をや伊吹山の鬼となりし鳴神の姫公儀の手の者より早く召し取ってみせい。
Aren't I technically free as a bird as long as I can kill everyone? Doesn't that hold true in real life as well? Total time, an hour and 50 minutes? Okay. I don't want to burn out on the game. And not that it's repetitive, but I guess I'll continue for now. I can't go down? Okay. Let me see the map for a second. This is a terrible map. This is a terrible map? That's a terrible map. What the hell is that? This is an awful map. Where am I, and where am I supposed to go? Because it wants me to go left, but I can't go left? Yeah, but the flag is down, but it wants me to go left. I'm so confused. Oh no, come on. I hate this so much. If they just made it a jump button. Yeah, the Z button. Alright, let me get this straight. The Z button is dedicated to making your map bigger. And actually, I can actually see now that I'm supposed to go back down. Yeah, okay. But I don't think they needed a button dedicated to the map. They could have made a button dedicated to jumping and then, you know, that would have been fixed instead of making it up on the control stick. Because when they require you to do platforming, good lord, is it annoying. And it seems like after every boss fight, I guess they're trying to, like, wind you down, so to speak, sort of give you a break, and so they don't have any combat, it's just running back and forth, but it is filler. It's basically just padding. I can't run down? Why can't I run down? Okay, that was weird. Even Bugs Bunny on the NES did that right, where it had those two stairs there, and you could go up or down depending on whether you're holding up or down on the control stick. But you can't hold up on the control stick because up on the control stick is jump. But that explains why it doesn't work. Okay, so I have to go back up and then to Issa. I wanted to switch. There we go. Yeah, I wanted to use Hell Spinner for that. Yeah, so basically they want you to remember the special moves for each of your blades that you're using at the time. And then use them appropriately. Because Cyclone's was very useful for that boss fight. Yeah, if you leave, you don't get a reward. But that's fine. I'm not bothered with that. And I go down now. That everyone? Everyone dead now? Yeah? Okay. There's an orange barrier here, okay. They're more annoying than anything else. Okay, so I don't need an orange blade. I just need to progress in the story, and then they give me the ability to break barriers. Okay, I thought I needed, like, an orange color blade. Speaking of blades, can I actually... I did get a new blade. So, let me see. 15. The weakest one is actually the one with Cyclone. Cyclo, Haze. This is Cross. Wow, attack is 30. Jesus. Oh, I don't have the strength of the Vitality for. I need to level up again. Okay, so I need to level up, actually, before I can use that. Alright, what about forging blades? Okay, I can forge new ones now, because I have the Ignomi. Okay. Earth Runner. I don't have enough strength and vitality for it. I do have enough strength and vitality for this one or this one. And I have two more blades here. Make that one. Might as well make anything I can actually equip. And I don't have enough soul. That's fine. Got plenty of spirit, though. Alright, so we got new blades. The weakest one is still my Cyclone one. Long Chop. Boost attack. What does boost attack mean? Does that just mean it does more damage? But how much more damage? Because this is 23 attack, this is 28 attack. So it's like, which one does more damage? Alright, let's do Hatsue. Replace Hayate. Ikna. That's 16 damage. There we go. Now we have all new damage swords and all new abilities. That's Slice, Phantom, and Log Chop. I don't know what any of that means, but we'll find out. The game actually is about 10 plus hours long, for reference. I looked up on how long to beat. I mean, I'm not rushing or anything, but you know. It was anywhere from 11 hours as a median to 18 hours at a leisure pace. So it's not a short game. That's a big one. Did I grab that? Couldn't even tell if I grabbed the big one. You'd say 10 hours is pretty short. Well, I mean, I come from a place where, you know, we have like 60-hour AAA games that are garbage. And then we have like 5-hour indie games that are amazing. So, 10 hours to me sounds pretty sexy. The fuck am I fighting? These are like Grandpa Kappas. And the only reason I know what a Kappa is because I play Animal Crossing. So that's the only thing. I mean, also considering the genre of game, for a action title that does things differently than other action titles, even still, action games lasting around 10 hours, that's, I'd say, pretty average for any sort of brawler action thing like this. I say like this, but nothing is quite like this. So. I mean, even this is actually longer than I would say Resident Evil 4, actually. I mean, then again, I've beaten Resident Evil 4 so many times that I probably regularly beat it at like 6 hours or so. I shall continue. I don't know when the stream will end today because I'm actually lucked out today because my mother actually went out to lunch, but I don't know how much longer they'll be out. It's been about 2 hours now. She said she'll be home from 3 to 4, so probably by the next save point, I'll probably just have to call it a stream, because I don't want to still be streaming and have my mother come home, because that'll just be annoying for everyone involved. So whenever I get to the next save point, is when I'll call it. Buy a souvenir. Sweet alcoholic drink. Soul power returns to you to the last shrine. Okay, so it brings me to a save point. I have 9 in my inventory. Why are maps so cheap? Boost attack power by 10%. Strength plus 1. Yeah, you can only equip 1 accessory though at a time, so I'd rather get quick draw 1. Cook ingredient. Oh, okay, that's not my inventory, that's his inventory, so he only has that many. So I can cook at some point. Okay. That's weird. You can only have... Hold on. I think you can only have so many items. I can unlock cooking now. Okay. Yeah, you can only have so many items in your quick thing. I see. Yeah, you can only have so many items. So I can replace this with Amazaki. Replace this with... I guess a bear pellet. I guess. Why not? I can cook now. By acquiring books, you'll be able to make sorts of dishes. Use prepare foods such as rice balls to restore your life flame, and hot pot cooking restores your life flame and gives you a special advantage. You cannot cook during a battle. Okay, so it's like The Witcher. You can't do the useful thing when it would be most useful. Yay for boiled radish. Okay. So delicious. And it gives me a shit ton of spirit, so. I mean, that's really the purpose of cooking and stuff, it seems, is just to give you more spirit to unlock more blades. Is she a prostitute? Oh, it's a tea house. Yeah, so they're always in order of, like, what gives you the most. Might as well get the biggest thing. I mean, nothing is expensive. That's the weird thing. Nothing is really expensive. I could eat this forever. It does look... It's like the developers wanted to make, like, food porn. I guess it's cheap because they want you to sort of eat everything. It's so weird, though. I mean, I don't think this really adds to the gameplay. I mean, it adds to my stomach. So, because that looks fucking delicious. Yeah, it seems he's full, but he's not actually full. It's just, I guess, a way to spend your money to get souls and spirits and shit. And you say I draw muscly dudes and flambus. Look at these guys. See, now that's not what a human looks like. But actually, if you are familiar with the art style of this guy, he also did the art for Grim Gamor, and he also did the art for Odin Spear. The artist is also, he did Dragon Crown on PS3 and also on PC. Dragon Crown is available also on PC as well. This is only on the Wii to my knowledge. Yeah, he did all the art for this, and he always makes sort of grotesque, exaggerated characters. I can see why they didn't do that for the main characters though, because they had to animate them quite severely, so that's why they're not exaggerated. It's actually, I believe it's the same guy. If I'm incorrect, let me know, but I'm pretty sure that it's the same exact dude. Because that's his art style, is that he exaggerates body proportions and things. Yeah, the whole point of those things is just to kill them all. I haven't used any of these special abilities yet. These are all new blades. I don't want to go that way. I don't really see the benefit in exploring. It's not like you get new blades or anything, you just get items which aren't that important. So, I mean, I'm sure I'm gonna backtrack at some point and have to go through the areas anyway. See that music? Listen to that music. That's nice fucking music, but it's such in the background all the time. I could listen to this soundtrack outside of the game, but in the game itself, it's just so downplayed. Hello, Hot Ghost. A mother worried about her children? Nonsense. My suspension of disbelief is gone. Mothers caring about their kids. Ha! 2017. Come on now. We gotta murder our babies. I'm not talking to the fox lady anymore. All she says is the same fucking shit. Oh yeah, that was the next save. It's only been 5 minutes, actually. Well, I'll keep going until 3 o'clock, which is 10 minutes away. I'll probably hit a save point by then. So, next save point. I'm just gonna call it next save point. That'll be the end of the stream. I noticed I didn't talk much this stream compared to other things, or at least most of my talking was mostly game design stuff, but honestly, there's really not much to either make fun of or... like, really talk about. I mean, it's all pretty self-explanatory. do I go down? That's completely wrong area anyway. Although there's a barrier for me to destroy, but again, I'm pretty sure I have to go backtrack anyway and go through the other area at some point. Odie jumping. Music sounds like something from Prince of Persia. Froggies! Jesus. Oh. Oh, that's what Phantom does, huh? Creates like a double of me, and then we go ahead and launch enemies in the air. Not that useful, actually. I mean, it's just a basic vertical attack. One of my earlier swords basically had the same thing, except it didn't create a phantom on it. It'd be cool if the phantom ability actually did something along the lines of, like, copy the move I did, and then just double it. That'd be cool, but it doesn't do that. That's what I thought it would do, but it doesn't. The map is not that big, then. I mean, each area can basically be traversed in about 7 minutes. I wonder how many hours they slaved over this art. It's a shame, because you run through most areas, but you could just stare at this for quite a long time. You gotta wonder how long they really took to slave away at this art. I granted, at this point, like, this is the dude's style, so it probably doesn't take him that long, actually. Probably still takes him a long fucking time, but I'm saying, like, you know, it might take me, like, you know, 2 weeks to do this kind of shit, right? But he maybe takes just 1 week. Or even less. That it? But does she ever say anything different? Okay, so she does say something different. Okay. These save points are actually pretty well placed. Is there nothing up there? Okay. Alright, folks, I did say that I was gonna end it at this time. I don't know how much longer I have before my mother comes home, so I'm gonna go ahead and end it here without causing an issue. So, you know, 2 years have passed since I last played this or so, and I gotta say, it clicks with me now. I don't know, it didn't click with me 2 years ago, but I gotta say, it's not a bad game. Because I thought it was either a bad game or just not for me, for my memory. And really, the only thing I remember about it was that jumping was up on the control stick, and that's not good. But it's still not good. That's still terrible. That's, like, the worst thing I can say about this game is the jumping is up on the control stick, and that's terrible. Bad. Especially when they make it a part of the combat. It was awful. Otherwise, though, game's pretty good. And, I mean, there's really nothing like it, as far as I know. I mean, there's other 2D action games, but they play like God of War, Dante's Inferno, Bayonetta. They play like those. This game does not play like those. It's more deliberate. I mean, granted, when it comes to regular fights, you can by and large get away from just spamming moves and you're fine. But when it comes to boss fights, you really gotta, like, think about what you're gonna do. More so than you would in other games. So, that's really all I gotta say. Other than that, have a pleasurable day, everyone. And I will see you all Wednesday. Probably, we'll be on consoles Wednesday. We should be, anyway, so. Probably gonna continue something instead of starting something new, but, yeah. See y'all then. Thanks for watching again, and rate the panda. And remember to do your homework.